Honorable Professor Tinsulet, chairpersons, international national faculty, friends, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I'm very grateful to MMDA for inviting me. I was just listening to the inaugural speech by Professor Tinsulet, and he was mentioning that MMDA is only 4 years old by the organization, by the symposium, by the rich faculty, and by the number of participants, it looks like 40-year-old already. And I congratulate you for the tremendous effort you must have put in 4 years' time to have this large symposium and event organized. Please accept my heartiest congratulations and from Pakistan and from international faculty in this regard. My introduction has been done. I am now the chair-elect for the IDF MENA region. MENA region is in fact Middle East and North Africa, so it involves 22 countries from Pakistan up to the Middle East, and then North Africa, which is Libya and Morocco and Egypt, etc. The reason I am showing this slide is only to make people know why I have been invited to talk on current status of diabetes care in Pakistan. I'll take you through these five headings, which are screening and prevalence, prioritization strategies, capacity building, management updates, and finally with some future directions. Just a few minutes ago, Professor Tinsulet has shared the numbers in Myanmar, which are like 2.5 million diabetics, 5 million IGTs. We have similar numbers in Pakistan. But right now, we are redefining the prevalence and screening in Pakistan. So for the screening, what we are suggesting that is still the gold standard diagnostic and screening test in Asians is modified GTT. We know the pressures coming from the Western world, especially across the Atlantic, etc., to use HbA1c as the diagnostic criteria. But we, in our parts of the world, yet have to have an evidence before moving to HbA1c. So what we are suggesting is that regional national studies are required before it can be included in national guidelines. We having 7 million diabetics are right now, having a survey done, which is National Diabetes Survey in Pakistan, and we are having these parameters: fasting blood glucose, 75 gram glucose load, HbA1c, and fasting lipid profile, along with the anthropometric measurements. And this is part of the Pakistan Medical and Research Council. It is approved by the National Bioethics Committee and supported by Ministry of Health Pakistan. Up till now, we have completed nearly 77% of the survey. So we are expecting in the forthcoming IDF in December, we'll be able to share the results and announce the recent survey. And as has been told already in Myanmar, like a prevalence of 10%, in fact, we are, up till now, the preliminary results are getting more than 10% of diabetes and nearly the same figures of 20% for IGT and IFG. And I think it's no surprise. Wherever the recent data are coming up in Asian parts, the numbers are going higher and higher. So let's move then to our main part of the talk, which is prioritization strategies. Wherever there are lack of resources or resource constraint, we ought to plan out or prioritize things where to concentrate first. So what we did quite a few years ago, and this is sharing my experience, we looked at the IDF consultative sections, and they had three priorities: diabetes education, diabetic foot, and diabetes and children. So we concentrated on these three in the last one decade. Let's just start with diabetes education. We started a university-based one-year diploma in diabetes education, and so far we have trained 148 diabetes educators which work in diabetic institutes and clinics in Pakistan. We were given international recognition of our diabetes education, and so when IDF decided to select 6 centers of excellence of diabetes education, in 2009, We are proud to have our center as one of those six centers.
Zifam, caring for well-being.